Tracy. Anyone who's everyone's doing it now.
Why?
Class is about to start.
Kathy Schmink told me that she heard that Tracy was in the back of a car with two boys at once playing tonsil hockey.
Oh!
In the news.
Oh!
I mean, Lip Larkin, how could you keep that beehive buffalo right over?
It's cool, Amber. I just thought it was a nice way to end the song.
Hey, look! Here they come! Special Ed!
Knock it off, IQ.
Special Ed.
Hi, Tracy. Sorry about your special Edness, but think about it as a testament to the record-breaking extremes of your hair. I'm so jealous.
Seen you before. Down at the gumball machine getting your Wrigley's?
I do 2 packs a day.
I thought sure it must make the muscles in your mouth mighty strong.
Not really. Probably just average.
Well, Tracy, you finally found yourself a title you could actually win. Miss Special Ed.
Rock it off, Amber.
Amber Ball Tussle, you got acne of the soul.
Ooh.
Rain down, down.
That's rich, Miss Trampy Tunnelard.
That's rude. Look who's talking.
Black Metal Free!
That's enough. Tracy Turnlad, Penny Lou Pingleton, you will remain here after class for detention.
Detention? Oh no, what's my mother gonna think?
Emma, why are you doing this? You seem to be bullying Tracy just because she's a good dancer.
You think she's good? Well, maybe you'd like to switch partners.
Well, maybe I would.
Amber and Link, since you two are so talkative, Link, why don't you recite one of Shakespeare's most classic lines?
Kiss my ass?
Link Larkin, you can join the rest of these delinquents in detention. Class dismissed.
You didn't have to do that, Link.
Hey, no problem. Besides, I've always wondered what it was like in detention.
You'd be surprised what happens down here.
Oh, Link, this is my friend Celia.
How are you doing?
How are you doing?
How are you doing? Okay. Amber's just jealous anyways. I'm sorry you got you put in detention too. It's okay. I'll just have to deal with Mother when I get
home. Wait, I know what makes you guys feel better. My mom was pitching a platter party down at our record shop in North Avenue. You guys wanna come check it out?
I've never been to North Avenue before. And I may come too?
You?
Imagine being invited to North Avenue. I know it feels so heavy.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way, friends, because not everybody does.
Whether they're on TV or not won't get me a recording contract. That came out. Tracy, I've been dancing and singing and smiling on that show for 3 years, waiting for it to lead to my big break. You? You've got brains, talent, personality. Me? I've got one chance to get seen nationwide. Saturday night is my only chance, and I'm not throwing that away. Look, I'm going. You should come too.
No! I want to do this, and so should you! It's what's right. Link, stay, please.
Sorry.
But you and me, together.
Sure. Me too. But I don't know. It's getting a little complicated. And there's always Amber. See you, darling.
I'm sorry, Tracy. Oh, Mama! How could I think that Nick Larkin could care about someone like me?
And why wouldn't he? You're a beautiful girl. This is just Eddie Fisher all over again.
Mama, don't tease. I really liked him. I've never felt anything like that before.
I'm sure he liked you too. It's just, boys are not the brightest things. Still, you give him time. I'm sure he'll figure out he's crazy about you.
You have to say that. You're my mother.
I'm more than your mother. I'm a woman in love. And we know about these things.
But, Tracy, he is right. Is it really worth risking your career for this?
I would have never got on the show if it wasn't for Seaweed. No, it's payback time.
That's my girl.
Okay, so here's how we're gonna do it. Tomorrow, everyone bring your mothers
and sisters
and meet around the corner from the studio and make signs!
Yes! And put words on them!
You and Elinez will walk out first, and me and Mama will be right behind you.
Excuse me?
We'll never be able to shove them back out the door with us blocking it.
Tracy, no one said anything about being on television. I'm sorry, I simply cannot appear on television at my present weight.
You can't let we restrict your fate. Look at me. I'm on TV.
Oh, well, Miss Motormouth, you're a celebrity. Well, I'm a simple housewife of indeterminate girth.
And the bigger the girth, the more you're worth. Mr. Turnblad, you don't mind that the missus here is an Apple American, do you?
Oh, not at all. I think of it as prime real estate.
Yeah, nice and roomy. You listen to me. Once upon a time, girl, I was just like you. Never let my extra large, large chest shine through. Hair was brown and nappy, never had no fun. I hid under a bushel, which is easier said than done. Then one day my grandma, who was big and stout, she said, you gotta love yourself from inside out. It's just as soon as I learned how to strut my funky stuff,
Robin!